defense. I think the highest sapper on New England's defense last year had like 6.5, and that's fairly standard over the years.
Playoffs this year.
Did you say if or when?
If. Even though the meddling could not be conclusively pinned on Russia, South Carolina Republican Senator Lindsey Graham already had plans for new sanctions on alleged meddlers.
Accessing this victory today for operators of a Detroit marijuana grow operation with a reported $1 million in plants. 36th District Court Judge Kenneth King dismissed all the charges against six people arrested in the raid, saying the facility was operating legally.
Today was the hearing where the judge summarily dismissed the entire case, ruling that that we were right, that the company did have the ability to temporarily operate as a medical marijuana facility, and as such had the ability to grow up to 1,500 plants. They were well under that amount and throughout the case.
That's Attorney Martin Morris of the Cannabis Legal Group. Morris says they are contemplating a civil suit against the city for the raid, which he believes targeted the minority-owned business on Jefferson Avenue. No word yet whether the Wayne County Prosecutor's Office plans to appeal the decision.
A small SUV crashed into a restaurant in Warren. It's not clear what caused the driver of the Nissan Cube to smash into Church's Chicken at 10 Mile and DeQuinter. No injuries being reported at this time.
WWJ News Time 308. Time for traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8th and from the Idle Dome. Motor Group Traffic Center brought to you this hour by BMW of Rochester Hills.
And we say good afternoon to KT.
Good afternoon, Brooke. Greg, I-75 northbound at I-696. An accident on your right shoulder looking to the AAA Jam Cam. You are slower from before 9 Mile Road on I-275 southbound at Ann Arbor Road. Got a crash on your right shoulder. And in Van Buren Township, Belleville Road northbound right after I-94. Got a crash blocking your right lane. Tipster Drew called that in. We've got road work that DTE is taking care of, a fallen pole. It's Plymouth Road between Haggerty and Lilly. You can expect road closures and some traffic shifts for another couple hours. If you see a problem on the road, give us a call on the WWJ Tipster line at 248-4236-WWJ. In the Idle Down Motor Group 24-Hour Traffic Center, KT4WWJ News Radio 950. Traffic and weather sponsored by the Carpet Guys.
And the AccuWeather forecast and meteorologist Dave Bowers looks like we're getting ready to warm things up again. Real hot this weekend, Dave.
Yeah, it is going to get to be pretty warm here by the weekend. That's right, Greg. It looks like pretty typical early August weather, except we still have at the moment this pesky upper low, which is over Illinois, lifting slowly northeastward. This is going to be generating some off and on rain here tonight. At the moment, the bulk of it is still over northwestern Ohio and Indiana, down to about Indianapolis. But that'll be creeping its way in our direction. So, like I said, we'll see rain off and on. Even hear some rumbles of thunder, low about 64. But that's really the bulk of it right through the forecast period. Very little rain going to be seen from tomorrow on. We just mentioned a stray shower tomorrow, but a lot of clouds, high about 81. Thursday, clouds, some sun, and high about 85. Friday also getting into the middle 80s, some muggy. A few places could see an afternoon shower, thunderstorm. Very spotty activity, though. And then no mention of rain for the weekend. Just a good deal of sunshine, quite warm and humid as we get close to 90. Right now we have 78 at Pontiac, 77 at City Airport, and 78 with clouds at Metro Airport, and a northeast wind at 11. This is AccuWeather meteorologist Dave Bowers on WJ News Radio 950.
Need new carpet in your house? Skip the code and shop at home with the Carpet Guys. The Carpet Guys make it easy to shop local and at a great price. Be wise. Call the Carpet Guys at 855-4-MY-GUYS.
It is the 12K Day Giveaway on WJ News Radio 950. Be listening 23 past the hour. Hear the keyword, your chance to win. $1,000. This portion of news sponsored by Levy Minnesota.
Police Sergeant Cleon Brown says he was subjected to racial taunts, including someone placing a black Santa Claus figurine in his Christmas stocking at the police station and officers whispering Black Lives Matter. The agreement says Brown will be on paid administrative leave until October 31st, when he'll resign.
Well, coming up 45 minutes before the baseball trading deadline, we'll see if the Tigers are making any more moves. Sports coming up next.
Starting at 7:10. In his first interview since signing with the Lakers.
Lakes and in Ann Arbor. I-94 eastbound between M-14 and U.S. 23. Roadwork's going to block one lane. That's going to be nightly starting at 9 tonight until 5 a.m. the next morning until Friday morning. See a problem on the road? Give us a call on the WWJ Tipster line at 248-423-6WWJ in the Idle Down Motor Group 24-hour traffic center. KT4WWJ News Radio 950.
And the exclusive WWJ Active Weather Forecast. Not Family Heating Cooling Electrical Weather Center. And Dave Bowers, what's ahead, Dave?
Greg Brook, and we are going to see some off and on rain tonight, even a thunderstorm below about 64. But after that, it's for the most part dry weather then, right through the upcoming weekend. Tomorrow, a lot of clouds. It's just a stray shower we're talking about. Most of the area is going to be dry, high about 81. Partly cloudy tomorrow night, mid 60s. A seasonably warm day Thursday with some sun, a high of 85. Friday, more of the same.
WWJ's Beth Fisher has more.
Festival creative director Meg Weichman says 180 films will be shown, including some starring Jane Fonda, like Coming Home and 9 to 5. Fonda is being honored at the festival.
Jane Fonda is receiving our Lifetime Achievement Award. She'll also do a one-on-one conversation with Michael Moore. We're very excited about that. Dick Cavett is coming with a new documentary about his relationship with Muhammad Ali.
Weichman says there will also be a documentary about Saturday Night Live's Daryl Hammond, who will also be at the festival. The festival runs through August 5th. Beth Fisher, WWJ News Radio 950.
WWJ News Time 3:22. It's time for the Feldman Report. If you're planning for your financial future, you're probably a happier person. I'm Murray Feldman with the Feldman Report on WWJ News Radio 950. What makes us happy in life? A financial industry study of American adults finds 80.